Hey, what is up guys? It's Muzmi. Welcome to another one of my guides where I'll be showing you how to unlock gold camo in the most efficient way on various weapons. Today the spotlight is going to be on the M82 semi-auto sniper rifle. This gun may look like an absolute beast, but don't be fooled, it is definitely the worst sniper in Cold War, at least right now. Because this gun is challenging, to say the least, I want to help you get it leveled up and get those challenges done as fast as possible so you can get one step closer to that diamond or even dark matter camo. Don't get me wrong though, it's still a pretty fun weapon to use once you get used to it. So first I'm going to explain how to level the gun up and get all the camos done in the most efficient way. Then at the end, I will show you the best attachments to use on the gun once you've got it maxed out, with a focus on aim down sight time for playing aggressively or quickscoping. In this first section of the video, we're going to start with leveling the M82. One of the biggest and most important tips that I can tell you about this is you want to be using double XP for this gun. Obviously, yes, ideally you'd use it for every gun, but especially this gun it's important to be using because it is just a bad weapon. So if you can get through those levels as quick as possible and unlock the attachments and camos quicker than normal, then that's ideal. And for anyone who doesn't know, if you go into Warzone or Modern Warfare and use a double XP token over there, it still counts in Cold War. So if you've got loads left hanging over from when you were playing Modern Warfare or Warzone, use them up. In terms of what maps or game modes to play when leveling this gun up, the best ones I'd say are Hardpoint, Domination, Control, Combined Arms, and Sniper Only Mosh Pit. So the reason for Hardpoint, Domination, Control, basically you want a game mode where there's an objective, because that just means there's not going to be as many enemies coming up randomly behind you or coming from weird locations. In theory, they should all be coming from predictable spawns or playing the objective, which makes your life a lot easier. As for Combined Arms, there's just more people to see. The maps are generally bigger, which favors snipers. So that's why Combined Arms is a pretty solid choice. And you've got objectives in Combined Arms. So like I was saying, makes the enemies more predictable. And then we've got Snipers Only Mosh Pit. This is actually a really, really good place to level up snipers, because obviously it's a much fairer place to do it. And another reason for this is that lethals and tacticals and score streak weapons are actually restricted, which makes it even more focused on the snipers. So you can't have people just running around with explosives or like tomahawks and stuff. It is purely snipers, which is actually really good. It gives you such a great chance to get this gun leveled up, and a lot of people are using the M82 in this playlist to get it leveled, so it is pretty much just an even playing field, which is great. In terms of specific maps you want to be trying to get when using this gun, any of them are fine, to be honest, if you're just going for leveling. There are some that are really good or really bad for doing certain camo challenges, but I'll go through those later on when we get to the camo section. Another great way to get an advantage whilst you're leveling up is to use the Frozen Chosen blueprint for the M82. This was unlocked by just logging in during the winter holidays. Hopefully you guys have got this unlocked, because it gives you some pretty nice attachments. You get some muzzle, you get a few of these attachments give you aim down sight speed, which is absolutely ideal. So it just gets you a bit ahead. For example, it comes with an airborne elastic wrap, which is really nice for the aim down sight time and everything. It's probably the best attachment in this slot. So things like that give you a massive step up from level one when you're using this gun. In terms of attachments that you use whilst along the way of leveling, basically you just want to be focusing on aim down sight time or things that just don't have any cons and give you some nice perks. For example, the stabilizer on the muzzle just gives you some idle sway, or when you unlock it, use the sound moderator. I found that was quite nice to have a silent sniper. And things like in the handle, basically you want to use speed tape when you get it, and then the jungle grip, the serpent wrap into the airborne elastic when you finally get there. Basically, whenever you get an attachment that gives you something good and doesn't affect your ADS time in a negative way, just put it on. You can also use the gunfighter wildcard whilst you're leveling this gun up. This just means you can use all 8 attachment slots, which can be useful, but I personally didn't think it was entirely necessary, but it's up to you. If you like using that wildcard, just go for it. All I'm going to say is don't worry too much about the leveling grind though, as getting the camo challenges done will keep you busy. In this section of the video, we're going to be talking about how to do all of the camo challenges in the most efficient way. So unlocked at level 1 from the very start is to get 200 eliminations with the M82. There's not much to say about this challenge. You will get this done before you've unlocked the rest of the challenges. You'll definitely have it done before you're level 50, so you don't need to worry about this. Just play and this will get done. Unlocked at level 5 is get 50 headshots medal with the M82. Again, this really isn't that bad. You're going to be hitting those headshots whilst you're sniping. It's just going to happen as you're leveling the gun up. Don't worry too much about this challenge. And next at level 10, you unlock the get 5 kills without dying 20 times with all kills coming from the M82 in multiplayer. This is probably the hardest challenge of them all, and you've really got to play quite defensively to get this challenge done, at least efficiently. All this camo challenge, any map is reasonable to do it on, but the smaller the map, the harder it is to get those kill streaks. However, with this challenge, I recommend not worrying too much about this one until you unlock the long shots challenge. And this is because the very defensive or passive playstyle that you need in order to get those long shots done consistently really complements getting 5 kill streak. So I would say just basically ignore this challenge until you get to level 20 when you unlock the long shots. Speaking of which, we'll move on to long shots now. So for this challenge, you have to get 50 long shot medals with the M82. As it's a sniper, it's not too bad to get done, but you're not going to get it done running around the map trying to quickscope everyone. So you do need to think about your playstyle whilst you're doing this. So some of the best map and game mode combinations to do this on are just combined arms in general. Satellite is a good map. If you go out into the dunes, it's really nice to get long shots over there. You can be that sniper out there. Miami is a nice map for it. There's so many long angles. It's really easy to get long shots going on that. Armada, both the combined arms and the regular multiplayer one, is a great map for this. It's a bit of a cheesy playstyle, but if you sit right at the back in the windows, you'll get long shots all day long. You're not going to be helping your team too much though. So if you're really trying to play the objective, then Armada is probably not the best map to be doing this on. Another surprisingly good map for getting long shots is actually Crossroads Strike. If you're playing Hardpoint or Control, this map's actually great for long shots. As you can see in the gameplay, if you go to this area and just lock this angle down, you will have no problem getting long shots. In a good game, you will easily get 10 to 15 long shots just holding down this angle. Absolutely great map if you can play Hardpoint or Control on it. One map I would try and stay away from if you're really focusing on long shots is Raid. I've found there's just not that many long angles, so it's really, really tough to get those long shots done. So if you're really trying to speed through these camo challenges, if you get Raid, just leave the lobby and find a new one because you're not going to get many long shots from it. Unlocked at level 30 is get 50 kills whilst holding your breath in multiplayer. This challenge, again, is just something that's going to happen. You basically will be holding your breath for pretty much every single kill you get with a sniper, so you don't need to think about this. It just happens. It's one of the easiest challenges for this sniper. And at level 40, you unlock the get 50 one-shot, one-kill medals with the M82 in multiplayer. Again, this challenge isn't too bad. You don't always one-shot one kill with this gun. Its damage is relatively low, but if you hit them in the chest or the head, it's always a one-hit kill. So found that once you've unlocked this challenge at level 40 and when you're leveling up to 50 to unlock the final challenge, you probably will get at least most of this done, so you don't need to worry about it. I've seen some advice out there saying go play hardcore in order to get this challenge done. I really don't think you need to, honestly. You probably one-shot your enemies 75-80% of the time with this gun. Realistically, you don't need to go to hardcore. Obviously, if you enjoy the hardcore game modes like an absolute madman, feel free to do it in there, because why not? It'll be a nice easy challenge for you. But if you don't like hardcore, don't feel like you have to go there and we'll just get this challenge done. And finally, unlocked at level 50 is kill 2 or more enemies rapidly 25 times in multiplayer. In other words, get 25 double kills whilst using this gun. You do unlock this challenge quite late in the gun, and it's probably the last one you'll complete just because you unlock it so late. But I found in order to really focus on this challenge and get it done much more efficiently, I'd actually recommend putting on a 2x, 3x, or a red dot sight on this gun. So just substitute one of the other attachments out, whichever one you fancy. I substituted out the silencer. By putting on a less zoomed in scope, it means you can be a lot more aggressive. You can get on those points and rack up those double kills a lot easier, especially in like Nuketown. That's a really good map for getting those double kills in. This challenge is basically the opposite of the 5 kill streak challenge. You're gonna find it much easier on the smaller maps, but bigger maps are fine too, because double kills really aren't actually that hard to get. So you've got double kills done. Congratulations, there's your gold weapon. It looks pretty nice in game. It looks even nicer. Anyway, let's move on to the final section now, which will be the best attachments to use on the M82 semi-auto sniper for playing aggressively or for quickscoping. Now, once you've got to this point, I'm assuming you've maxed the weapon level, or at least very close, and that you've got most, if not all, of the attachments. As I mentioned at the start, these attachments will be focused on aggressive playing with snipers, so aim down sight time is the primary focus here. I am just going to start by talking through the 5 attachment setup, so the non-gunfighter wildcard attachments. Then once we've got those in, I'll fill in the gunfighter attachments afterwards. So let's get straight into it. For the optic, I find that you really don't need to change anything. The default scope that you get is actually really nice. So on the muzzle, I personally like using the sound moderator. Just having that silence taking you off the minimap and really disguising where your shots are coming from is really nice on this sniper. However, if you don't like using it, then I would substitute it out for the 22.6 inch combat recon barrel. This gun doesn't have crazy good bullet velocity at its base levels, so increasing that is always nice. So that's an option to use instead of the suppressor if you want to. We do not use a body on this gun. None of them provide much benefit, and quite a few of them affect your aim down sight time and sprint to fire time, so we just ignore this for now. On the underbarrel, the bipod is absolutely solid. Vertical recoil and horizontal recoil is actually really nice on this gun for when you're trying to get those rapid fire shots in, because without this, when you're scoped in, the recoil is absolutely wild, so it's nice to have something that really compensates for that. So the magazine size without anything on is 5, which isn't that much for a semi-auto sniper, so I just stuck with the 7-round mag. This gives you obviously increased capacity, but you do lose a bit of reload quickness, but you're not that bothered, because if you're reloading, you've probably backed off and are relatively safe. The 7-round speed mag is an option, but you lose ADS time, which I just don't like, so that's why I just go for the 7 round mag. On the handle, it's pretty much a no-brainer. The airborne elastic wrap is the way to go. It gives you the most aim down sight time of 12%. And for the stock, I would recommend using the Raider pad. You get a lot of sprint to fire time. You get some nice mobility with the aim walking move speed, 40% increase, which is huge. But you do lose a lot of hipfire accuracy. If you're struggling to hipfire, I'd take off the Raider pad and use the CQB pad. This gives you the same sprint to fire time, but you lose half as much hipfire accuracy, which is a massive difference. But personally, I found the Raider pad was absolutely fine, and that's what I'm going to stick on. So those are the 5 base attachments that I recommend you use. They're the best for playing aggressively. They're the best for quickscoping by a mile on this gun. If you want even more attachments, then stick Gunfighter on, and these are the attachments I'd recommend using. So for the optic, you don't have to actually put anything on this again. Like I said, I just like the base scope. It's actually really quite nice. But if you want to try anything else like the Hangman scope or the SUSAT, those are pretty solid sights, then go for it. Just have an experiment, see if there's a sight you prefer over the base one. But for me personally, I don't even put an optic on when I'm using Gunfighter. So for the barrel, I like to go for the 22.6 inch combat recon barrel. It gives you 75% bullet velocity, which is really nice. You do lose some idle sway control, which isn't ideal. So if you're struggling with that, then just go for the 22.2 inch extended. This gives you 25% bullet velocity for no cons, which is, you know, you can't argue with that. Personally, I'm going to stick on the combat recon. And on the body, you've got 2 choices here. You've either got the steady aim laser, which gives you 30% hipfire accuracy for no cons, pretty solid, or you go for the SOF target designator. This gives you some reveal distance. If that's something you like, then it gives you a lot of that for no cons, which is pretty nice. But personally, I'd go steady aim laser. This right here that you can see on screen is the final attachment with all the Gunfighter attachments. When you're using this gun for the first time, please don't get too disheartened when you find out how bad it is. Once you get the attachments going, once you get used to it, it's actually quite fun to use. It's definitely not the best sniper in the game, I'm telling you that for sure. I'm not trying to say it is, but it's definitely not the worst weapon in the game. If you've made it this far, first of all, thank you so much. I really appreciate you watching the whole video. Hopefully you found it really useful and interesting, and I hope you enjoyed the gameplay too. Please do leave a like or a comment or a subscribe or all of the above. Any support is much appreciated. Have fun unlocking your gold M82.